Canada is a country rooted in the rule of law, and the protection of our citizens is paramount. That's why, when our law enforcement and intelligence officials began pursuing credible allegations that agents of the Government of India were directly involved in the killing of a Canadian citizen, Hardeep Singh Nijjar, on Canadian soil, we responded. Nous avons partagé nos inquiétudes avec le gouvernement de l'Inde et lui avons demandé de travailler avec nous pour faire la lumière sur cet important enjeu. En même temps, les services de police et les organismes de sécurité ont utilisé tous leurs outils pour assurer la sécurité des Canadiens. Aujourd'hui, étant donné les nouvelles preuves présentées par la GRC, nous prenons des mesures additionnelles pour protéger les Canadiens. As the RCMP commissioner stated earlier, they have clear and compelling evidence that agents of the Government of India have engaged in and continue to engage in activities that pose a significant threat to public safety. This includes clandestine information gathering techniques, coercive behavior targeting South Asian Canadians, and involvement in over a dozen threatening and violent acts, including murder. This is unacceptable. While attempts have been made by the RCMP and national security officials to work with the Government of India and Indian law enforcement counterparts on this matter, they have been repeatedly refused. This is why, this weekend, Canadian officials took an extraordinary step. They met with Indian officials to share RCMP evidence, which concluded six agents of the Government of India are persons of interest in criminal activities. And despite repeated requests to the Government of India, it has decided not to cooperate. Étant donné le fait que le gouvernement de l'Inde refuse toujours de coopérer, ma collègue, la ministre Joly, n'avait qu'un seul choix. Aujourd'hui, elle a émis un avis d'expulsion pour ces six individus. Ils doivent quitter le Canada. Ils ne seront plus en mesure d'agir à titre de diplomate au Canada, ni d'entrer à nouveau au Canada, peu importe la raison. Let me be clear. The evidence brought to light by the RCMP cannot be ignored. It leads to one conclusion. It is necessary to disrupt the criminal activities that continue to pose a threat to public safety in Canada. That is why we acted. Because we will always, first and foremost, stand for the rights of Canadians to feel safe and secure in their own country. We will never tolerate the involvement of a foreign government threatening and killing Canadian citizens on Canadian soil, a deeply unacceptable violation of Canada's sovereignty and of international law. À nouveau, nous demandons au gouvernement de l'Inde de coopérer avec nous sur cette enquête, de mettre fin à son inaction et à sa rhétorique trompeuse, de reconnaître la crédibilité et la sévérité des preuves et des informations que nous avons partagées jusqu'à maintenant, et de réitérer de façon claire que sa position sur les opérations extrajudiciaires à l'étranger sera désormais sans équivoque alignée avec le droit international. Le Canada va toujours défendre l'état de droit et les principes fondamentaux sur lesquels s'appuient les sociétés libres et démocratiques. Nous incitons le gouvernement de l'Inde à en faire de même. I know the events of the past year and today's revelations have shaken many Canadians, particularly those in the Indo-Canadian and Sikh community. Many of you are angry, upset, frightened. I get that. This shouldn't happen. Canada and India have a long and storied history rooted in people-to-people ties, business, and trade. But we cannot abide by what we're seeing right now. Canada fully respects the sovereignty and territorial integrity of India. We expect the Indian government to do the same for Canada. As Prime Minister, it is my responsibility to provide reassurance to those who are feeling their safety has been compromised. But most importantly, it is my responsibility to take action and to never hesitate in doing what is necessary to protect Canadians. That is precisely what we are doing today.